Hello everyone, welcome to Topper IAS. So we will see again today important topic. Actually, we are continuing with the labor reforms and the labor codes that have been brought in. Okay, today also we will continue with that discussion. Okay, so we have seen, you know, labor codes. We have discussed the issues with the labor, you know, labor sphere, like, you know, the n number of issues, like complexity of labor laws, since labor is a concurrent subject, both center and states have come out with n number of laws. So this has increased the complexity, like, you know, multiple definitions, inconsistent definitions and all. And other issues are also, like, you know, threshold issue, means size of establishments to which, you know, labor laws should be applicable. That is also an issue. Okay. And other things like updating the, you know, labor laws, in the sense with respect to new economic activities, new workforce, people will be involved in new economic activities, they also should be brought under the regulation, like gig workers and all. So those are all the issues. We have seen them in our previous episode. So based on that, government, so NCL has made recommendation, like, already to broadly categorize these laws. So government has now come out with four labor codes. Okay, so that's what, a brief introduction. Again, we have already seen a second National Commission on Labor recommended consolidation of central labor laws. It is observed that numerous labor laws, both at the center and states, because of concurrent subject labor being, and to improve ease of compliance and ensure uniformity in labor laws, NCL recommended consolidation of central labor laws into broader groups. What kind of groups? Like industrial relations, wages, social security, safety, welfare, and working conditions. Okay. So to modernize and to simplify the labor regulation, four labor codes have been introduced now. They are, like, code on wages, industrial relations code, social security code, and occupational safety health working conditions code. Okay, so before you see, if you are not gone through the previous series, please watch that episode, then after that you can get into this one. Okay, because first you know what are the issues, only then you will know how the particular code is going to address a issue. Okay, so one, we will see with respect to code on wages. Okay, code on wages is going to replace four laws: Minimum Wages Act 1948, Payment of Wages Act, Payment of Bonus Act, and Equal Remuneration Act of 1976. So all these four acts will be replaced by a single, you know, code on wages. So this shows, like, you know, n number of laws were there, right? So you broadly categorize them, so reduce the number of laws, so these all together will be subsumed, replaced with a single law. Okay. And as a part of this code on wages, certain things you should know. One is, like, you know, floor wage. So what is this floor wage? A minimum of amount will be set up wage. Okay, as per the code, central government will be fixing the floor wage considering the workers' living standards. Okay, and this floor wage will be depending on the geographical location, so it will be varying, maybe north, east, south, west. So geographical variations based on the location, right? On that terms, floor wages will also vary. Okay, and what is the significance of floor wage? You know, the minimum wages decided by the central or state governments, okay, should be above the floor wages. I'm sorry, it should be above the floor wages. Okay, so what are the minimum wages? You are aware of the basic, you know, meaning, like, you know, minimum wages, those wages which are, you know, necessary to satisfy basic needs, like, you know, food, clothing, and shelter. So added to that, if you add, you know, health facilities, educational facilities, that becomes a living wage. Okay, so what it is saying, the code on wages, minimum wages will be decided by the central or state government, and this minimum wage will be above the floor wage that is fixed. Okay, and in case the existing minimum wages are higher than the floor wages, so before already floor wages is fixed, if the minimum wages are higher than that, so central or state government cannot reduce the minimum wages. So do not bring minimum wages down. Okay, that's what the meaning is. While fixing the minimum wages, government should take into account the difficulty level of work and the workers' skill level also. So depending on that, minimum wages will be fixed. And the amount, the minimum wage that is fixed will be reviewed by the government at least every 5 years. Okay, this will be done. Then also we have, you know, advisory boards. Advisory boards will be set up by central and state governments together, and this will be consisting of, you know, equal number of employees and employers, state government representatives and independent persons also. Okay, and 1/3 of the board members will be women representatives, women members. And what the function of this board is, you know, this board will be advising the governments on minimum wage fixing and increasing the employment opportunities for women also. Okay, so one thing you also see here, you know, gender aspect. So gender component is also given due, you know, weightage, like in the sense by having women representatives, by, you know, so that will be helping, you know, coming out with the new measures to increase employment opportunities for women. So you already know women. So women part of society will be facing n number of issues, right? So as a societal group, they face the issues. Among many issues related to work and economy is also issue to women. She also faces a number of issues in the workplace, like sexual violence, sexual harassment, and glass ceiling, you know, not paid enough, not hired to higher position. Okay, so restrictions. So n number of, you know, discrimination she faces even in workplaces also. So there is a to avoid such a gender biases, gender discrimination. So one of the way the code on wages deals with such a issue of women is coming out with, you know, members, 1/3 members of advisory boards being women representatives. Okay, and other works will be as a part of code on wages. We have, like, you know, a number of working hours will be fixed by the central or state governments. Okay, and if there is in case of overtime work, and then the worker is entitled to overtime compensation, which should be at least twice the normal wages. Okay, the if he works for extra hours, that will be the wages will be twice the normal wages. Okay, and then also something called a code specifies penalties for offenses committed by an employer. Okay, so there are penalties for the offenses. So what kind of penalty, what qualifies for a offense? Okay, if there is any contravention to the provision of the code, okay, that will become an offense. If somebody is paying less than the minimum wages, that will also become an offense. And when the offense is committed, you know, the maximum punishment is 3 month imprisonment, imprisonment along with the fine of up to ₹1 lakh. So this is also provided. Okay, so just try to remember, this is one code on wages. Out of the 4 codes, we have seen 1 code. Remaining 3 we'll be seeing in the next this one video. And thing is, just try to link with respect to mains. So straight away question can be asked with respect to provisions of code on wages. Okay, a factual question can be asked. Okay, factual question asking you to write the important provisions of the code on wages. Straight factual question or analytical questions can be asked. Okay, what do you where, you know, you need to assimilate the information, knowledge, and give the answers by analyzing the statement. So questions like, you know, like labor reforms are a transformative to, you know, Indian economy, the comment or critically analyze. Okay, so straight away can be asked in GS3 analytical questions, you know, because obviously we have economic activities, so there are factors of productions, right? Factors of production. Among the factors of production, we have land, labor, okay, capital, and other things also. So obviously it is important that the factor of production, labor, is taken, you know, issues in the labor sphere is addressed, because otherwise it will hamper the economic activity. So what, so to address such issues, so what are, first you should know what are all the issues that the labor sphere faces. So once you know the issues, obviously by analyzing how the labor codes overcome the issues, you will see that it is going to make a transformative change in the economic activity. And other thing, you also know the importance that the government lays on improving ease of doing business also, right? Ease of doing business is emphasized. So by flexible labor laws, by modernizing the labor laws, by reducing the compliance, all these things, you know, help create a positive enabling environment for the businesses, economic activities. So more and more companies will be willing to, you know, set up their, you know, industries in India. So these all things, you know, possible only when we have, you know, flexible and modern labor laws, regulations. Okay. So these labor codes are, you know, one of the few means to achieve such a positive outcome for the economy. Okay. So try to link in GS3, you can get GS3 analytical questions, and in GS2, you can get the codes straight away asking you the right about provisions and all. Okay. So one code we have seen, in next video, we'll be seeing the remaining three codes. Okay. Then we will also see what are the shortcomings of the videos of these codes also. Okay. So that's it for today. You can also download the PDF of this document. So in the link that is, you know, given below. Thank you.